The Greens. Yes, it's colour, commonly found in nature. It's also known by uncles across Australia as the Lefty Party, which, funnily enough, is one of the only parties without party at the end of its name. It's just the Greens. Anyway, it's currently led by this guy?
Google it, mate.
Oh, yes, that's right. Adam Bandt. But where did the Greens come from and who are they now? The Australian Greens grew from Australia's environmental protest movement in the 1970s. Protesters in Tasmania went on to lead the United Tasmania Group, which the Greens claim was the first Green Party anywhere in the world. State-based Green parties ended up banding together in 1992 to form the Australian Greens. Bob Brown was their leader. Since then, they've expanded their platform to champion not only environmental issues, but social issues like Australia's refugee intake. It's also sought to strengthen its position in Parliament by at times teaming up with Labor. In 2010, it entered an agreement with the Labor leader, Julia Gillard, to vote with the ALP and oppose any motion of no confidence in the government from non-Greens members. But the deal ended in 2013 when the Greens accused Labor of siding with the mining industry. When Christine Milne left in 2015, the leadership role was taken over by Richard Di Natale, a man who loved a turtleneck. He resigned as leader in 2020, which brings us to Adam Bandt. The Greens are running with some pretty progressive ideas this election: free dental care, legalise tax and regulate cannabis, and impose an annual 6% tax on the net wealth of Australia's richest 122 people. So how does the party stack up to its original manifesto?
The Greens are no longer just the environmental party that they started out being. They're much more. They have policies right across the spectrum, and they go to economic redistribution and attacking greed and a range of other things. The Greens have changed in the sense that they are now a part of the furniture. They were initially very much a party of protest. They were there to shake things up and to really make an impact. And I think, to be fair, that's what they did.